We want to determine negative 2 ninths minus 5 ninths plus 1 ninth. So the first thing we should recognize is that we're adding and subtracting fractions that have a common denominator of 9, and therefore the result will also have a denominator of 9. The numerator is going to be the sum and difference of the numerators. So the numerator is going to be negative 2 minus 5 plus 1. And now let's work on simplifying the numerator. Because subtracting a positive is the same as adding a negative, let's write minus 5 as plus negative 5. So the numerator can also be written as negative 2 plus negative 5 plus 1. Now let's determine negative 2 plus negative 5 using the formal rules for adding signed numbers. Because they're both negative, we'll use the rules for adding two numbers with the same sign. So step one is to add their opposite values, and step two, we give the sum the same sign or a common sign. So we first determine the opposite value of negative 2, which equals 2, and the opposite value of negative 5, which is 5. Now we find the sum, 2 plus 5 is 7, but because both numbers are negative, negative 2 plus negative 5 is equal to negative 7. So this simplifies to negative 7 plus 1 over 9. And now we'll use the formal rules for adding negative 7 and positive 1. So we'll use the rules for adding two numbers with different signs. Step 1, we find the difference of their absolute values. And then step 2, we give the sum the same sign as a number with a greater absolute value. So the absolute value of negative 7 is 7. The absolute value of 1 is 1. When we find the difference, it's always the smaller value subtracted from the larger value. 7 minus 1 is equal to 6, but because negative 7 has the larger opposite value, the sum is negative 6, which gives us negative 6 ninths. This is the result, but notice how 6 and 9 do share a common factor of 3, and therefore we need to simplify the fraction. To simplify, we'll divide the numerator and denominator by 3. Negative 6 divided by 3 is equal to negative 2, and 9 divided by 3 is equal to 3. The final result simplifies to negative 2/3. Now, it was quite a bit of work to follow these formal rules to determine negative 2 plus negative 5 plus 1. It might be much easier to think of a negative number as a loss of money and a positive number as a gain of money. For example, we can view negative 2 plus negative 5 as losing $2 and then losing $5, which would be a loss of $7, giving a sum of negative 7. And then for negative 7 plus 1, we can think of this as a loss of $7 and then a gain of $1, leaving us with a loss of $6 or negative 6. So if we can make sense of adding and subtracting signed numbers using a money analogy, that can sometimes help our understanding of adding signed numbers. I hope you found this helpful.